welcome to the all-new Two-Track Tombstone with me, Jay Tombstone. It's over. After 8.5 years of working at military promotions, I just left my last day at military promotions, and it was not a good one. I ran a bunch of errands, first of all. When I got back from the errands, Bob was on the phone with Cox, which is our phone company. And I walk in and I hear, Jay Tombstone, Jay Tombstone. He's saying my name 20 times and he's pissed off on the phone. Apparently, last year, we had 5 phone lines, I think. And we canceled one. Let me be clear that in the 8 years I worked there, I have never made a decision of that business without Bob. It was never. I never did anything on my own. I always kind of like, you know, especially fucking what is happening here. So apparently I remember canceling the phone line, and it was probably a case of him saying, hey, cancel the phone line, you do it. And I called and did it. Apparently when we canceled that phone line, that voided that contract that was in effect then, and then automatically renewed the contract for the 4 remaining lines, or however it worked, whatever. So Bob's having this long discussion on the phone with Cox Cable, and after he hangs up, he's very clearly tells me that I signed a contract with the phone company, and now he is responsible for the remainder of the contract. Like, I've just done something willy-nilly. I was so disappointed. I was so mad and yet sad. Like, I was trying, like, I, for the 8.5, you know, and I was trying to wait until that very last day, and even on the last day, not snap at him, not say anything, and I didn't snap at him, but, you know, trying to give my best 100% every second of the whole thing, and I did. But the fact that I left, and I left with him saying that now he's responsible for $3,000 because of my mistake. I cried on the way home. I was as mad as I could be, but part of me felt like what I would let my lifelong idol boy George talk for me in this song from their latest album, Culture Club. You know, when you've done everything you can, and yet it's still not enough. And it's never you. It's not me. I've done all I could do. It just upset me that on the last day, it ends with him telling me that I've made a $3,000 mistake. Anyway, Culture Club with Less Than Perfect.
Maybe I can conquer you completely. everything that I do. I fool the world most of the time, but there's no fooling you. If I change my attitude, maybe I can conquer you completely.
My lifelong idol, Boy George, I Let You Down. That is Less Than Perfect by Culture Club. You know, and it sucks that it ended like that, because the truth is, Bob let me down. I didn't let him down. He's the one who gave up on his business. He's the one who started crabbing, saying, I'm so bored with my business. Like, you have a successful business, he's taking 5 vacations a year, and he's crabbing because he's bored with his business. And then, I still don't know if he ever made the connection that him being bored with his business and showing up less and less was the reason why his business was failing and making less and less. I don't think he ever put that together, because his narrative, when he tells other people, I've heard him tell other people, his narrative is that that sequestering, there was like a sequestering when the government shut down 2 years ago. Do y'all remember that? Something, I don't even understand a government at that level where they shut down the government supposedly, but stuff's still happening, but people can't get in public parks. I don't even understand all that. It's beyond my comprehension. But at some point, but remember, they cut spending. And Bob tells people that when the sequestering happened, that that affected his business, and he's never quite recovered from that. I feel the truth is Bob is suffering from depression, and he doesn't want to get, you know, address it. Although he asked me for, like, my therapist number. I gave him my therapist number. He just doesn't follow through with it. Anyway, Anyway, I'm just rambling because I'm excited. I'm mad. I cried on the way home. I'm not crying anymore. But it's over. I had to talk with Kat today. Kat's going at the radio station, and you know, she's going to work with me. I have this vision though now, and it's hard once this happens to me. Once I kind of get my mindset on something, I don't know that I can turn it away. But there's a new radio station in New Orleans called WHIV, and I feel it's my calling. I'm feeling like it's my calling, just like when I was doing the comedy shows in the quarter. And I've kind of missed that for a while, that like, I know what I need to be doing, and that's it. I feel I've been a little aimless lately. And WHIV is kind of, I feel like, maybe. I haven't even, you know, I've only looked at their website. I haven't even rewritten my resume or anything yet, but I'm getting through Mardi Gras first. Because Mardi Gras, Crew de Vue starts, like, oh my God. I don't know how long this podcast is going to be because I'm just rambling and ranting. It's going to be over 15 minutes, I'm telling you that. But it's kind of an epic day for me. It's like the last of an 8.5 year job. And yeah, I just want to kind of record and just ramble as much as I can. You don't have to listen if you don't want to. And then, you know, there's only going to be two songs. Because this is Two Track Tombstone. Oh, Drunk Tunes. The third Saturday of every month. Drunk Tunes starting on the 21st. We had to cancel the January debut of Drunk Tunes because someone in Carlos's family died, and we just didn't. We technically could have done the show without him, but we didn't want to. It just didn't seem right. We just, and especially since it was kind of the beginning, we just decided to delay the beginning another month. But starting this month, Drunk Tunes, the third Saturday of every month at the Hi-Ho Lounge. I'm so excited about that. Crew de Vue is this weekend. I'm so excited about that. There's going to be a Gay Jay's play-by-play of the Super Bowl. I know it's me and Lene. I'm not sure who else is going to be involved. I hope Stevie's going to be there, but I don't even know yet, but I've agreed to do it. That's happening this Sunday, Super Bowl Sunday. With that, and all that emotion, and as mad as I was, and, you know, all that. I wanted to play another emotional song, and Pistol Pete sang this song for me last night. He sang it to me live on his little ukulele. Pistol Pete is visiting from New York right now. He says he's going to be moving to Asia soon. He's moving to China. I wish him well. I think he's just moving because there's hot young Asian boys, but, you know, it's not a bad reason to move. This is Patti Smith with Pissing in a River, and somehow I'm just feeling this song right now. Patti Smith, Pissing in a River.
Pissing in a river, watching it rise, tattoo fingers shy away from me, voices mesmerize, voices picking and seeing.